Іван Мазепа, гетьман війська Запорозького.
Іван Мазепа, гетьман of Zaporizhian Host. For Ukrainians, he is a hero, while for Russians, a traitor. In total, Mazepa ruled the state for 22 years, first as the head of the left bank Ukraine, and then the whole Dnieper Ukraine. For a long time, he was a friend of Russian Emperor Peter I. He supported the Moscow Kingdom in the Northern War with Sweden. However, in 1708, he took the side of the Swedes, putting the interests of Ukraine above loyalty to the Russian Tsar.
Why was the Swedish king who fought against Moscow a valuable ally in a fight for Ukrainian independence? Because he had a reputation of an outstanding commander who never suffered a defeat until the Battle of Poltava in 1709. Betting on a possible win, Mazepa made a correct geopolitical choice.
Having found out about the decision made by Mazepa, Peter I ordered to raise the capital of Hetman, the town of Baturin. Mazepa himself was anathematized.
These curses imposed by the Russian Orthodox Church are still being announced by Muscovite priests. This is a very Moscow-style tradition to curse their opponents. Yet, if you are being cursed by your enemies, it means you are moving in the right direction.
Due to the commitment to the ideas of unification and independence of Ukraine, Mazepa became an idol and an example for many generations to come. Being a rich man, Hetman Mazepa was a well-known patron of arts. This building of the Kyiv-Mohyla Academy was built using the money donated by Ivan Mazepa. The hetman was a patron to many educational institutions. He purchased books and rare manuscripts for their libraries.
During the reign of Hetman Ivan Mazepa, the Kyiv-Mohyla College transformed from a theological institution into a full-scale academy. All in all, it became the first university on the territory of Ukraine. Thanks to the efforts put in by Mazepa, it gained the status of an academy.
Mazepa also gave a lot of attention to religion. The hetman believed the Ukrainian church to be an ideological basis for a nation. That is why he spent his own money to build and renovate churches. Many Ukrainian churches were rebuilt thanks to Mazepa.
For example, St. Michael's Cathedral, that was unfortunately destroyed. Several churches on the territory of the Kyiv-Pechersk Lavra were built, and most churches rebuilt using his donations. The bell tower of the St. Sophia Cathedral was constructed on his donations. This list is too long to ignore the role of Mazepa in the history of the Ukrainian church.
To Mazepa, a patron of arts and culture, a monument in Kyiv was dedicated. It included the list of Ukrainian cultural heritage sites constructed or built on his money.
George Byron, Victor Hugo, Prosper Mérimée wrote about Mazepa. None of the Ukrainian politicians had as many books written about them as Ivan Mazepa. He was one of the most famous politicians of the 18th century, and he gained a huge respect of other contemporaries.
Ivan Mazepa is one of the most popular Ukrainian historical figures. More than 200 engravings, 50 paintings, 20 musical pieces and 15 literature writings were devoted to him, as well as 6 sculptures. Reported by Lyubov Zadorozhna, UATV.